Let's start with the block in between the thighs, and just find a position where you can stretch your arms forward, back, and not knock into anything. And then looking at our feet, so our toes want to point forward to the front. And let's just start by lifting the toes up and pressing them down a couple of times, just to feel the feet. So it's not even about finding balance or even breathing at the moment, just feeling the feet, lifting the toes up, spreading the toes out, and then pressing them into the floor. And we're going to do exactly the same now with the heels. So just lift the heels up. And as you do that, squeeze your inner thighs. Breathing out, maybe press the heels down with resistance to grow from the crown of the head. And let's do that again. Breathing in. Now as you lift up. And then breathing out, maybe as you anchor the heels down. And we're going to do one more and then focus on the breath. Breathing in. The feeling is that I'm pushing the floor away with my toes. And then grounding the feet as I breathe out. Anchor feet down now. Lengthen the thigh muscle up. Slide the tailbone down. Think of your shoulders plugged into your armpits. Let's bring our hands to our ribs. And just start breathing deeply into our hands. So when you breathe in, still flows. But now you really want to push your hands out with your breath. So the ribs expand, but not the stomach. Breathe out through the mouth. Squeeze your ribs towards each other slightly down. Squeeze your stomach in and the block. Let's do that again. Breathing in through the nose. Just try and grow, lengthen. Breathe out through the mouth. Make a sound as you breathe out. Squeeze your ribs towards each other, down stomach and the block. Two more. Breathing in. Open it up. Breathing out. One more, we'll start moving our arms. Breathing in. Trying to open a little bit more the ribs. Growing a little bit more. Breathing out, squeezing the ribs in, squeezing the stomach back and the deep core. Relax the arm and let's move with that breath. So you're breathing in, lifting the arms up so that your arms are in line with your ears. And then breathing out, press the arms down, squeeze the stomach in and the block. And keep doing that. Breathing in, lifting up. You'll let me know if the music is too high. I can lower it down, yeah? Exhale. Nice to see you all. Nice to see you come back. Jacob, Ben, and I think Carlos just logged in. Yes, welcome. Breathing in. Lifting up. Nice to see you all. Breathing out. Let's keep the left arm down, palms facing, and lift only the right arm up. Breathing in as you lift. Lengthen up and down. Breathe out. Cross your arms and then change them round. Breathing in. Lift. Breathing out, change. Breathing in, lift. Breathing out on the change. We're going to do about four more. Just for those that have just come, we're using the block in between our inner thighs if you've got one, or a ball, or a cushion, or nothing. But the feet are about hip distance apart if you haven't got anything. And you want to just concentrate on the posture. Lengthen on the breath in, squeeze the core on the breath out. Let's do two more and stay with our right arm up. So breathe. Breathing out on the change, and when your right arm stays up, or stay it, keep it up. Exhaling, grab the head, push it to the right. Just anchor the shoulders down, squeeze the stomach in, and then breathe and come back to center. And let's do that again. Exhaling, squeeze the block, the stomach, the ribs slightly, and the head, pull it on just the head. Breathing in, come back to center. And again, exhaling, pull the head. Inhale, back to center. So that was three. Now we're going to do three with a side bend. So as you breathe out, first the head, then involve your shoulders, squeeze your stomach in, push your hips, your feet down, and see if you can roll to the side. Inhale, coming back up through the side. And again, exhale. So you've got two more, squeezing your inner thighs, pushing your feet down, trying to push your right shoulder forward. It tends to go back. Inhaling, coming back up through the center. And again, exhaling, first your head, then your shoulders. Just try to roll one vertebra at a time. Just hold it here this time. Do little bounces with your hips forward and to the left. Very subtle, just to go deeper into the stretch. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. See if you can melt a little bit more. 2, and 1. Hold it there. Drop right arm down. Lift the left arm up. Try and hang with your body. Reach up and down with your eyes. Relax your head. Hold it there. And then coming back up through the center, lengthen the left arm up. Same thing on the side. Grab your head and pull it towards the left as you exhale. Breathing in, coming back to center. Nice. Exhaling again, pull the head. Try to plug the shoulders down. And then inhale, come back to center. You've got one more. As you exhale, you're going to the side. And now you're turning it into that side bend. So you're going to go sideways with your shoulders, with your hips forward slightly to the right. Nice. Breathing in, back to center. Let's do two more. Breathing out. First your head. Try and melt the head. Bend the shoulders. Bend the ribs. Pushing the hips forward, the feet down. Really stretch the right side of your body. Breathing in, coming back up. Don't rush you. But on the third one, we're staying there. So first your head. Shoulders. Squeeze the stomach in. Push the hips forward. Hold it there. And see if you can just bounce the hips to the left. Now exhaling for 8, 7. Just softly. 4 more, 3, and 2, and 1. Drop the left arm up, down. Try to reach the right one up. See if you can relax the shoulders, relax the head. Look forward, push the hips forward slightly to the right. Hold it there. And then breathe in. Lengthen both arms up. Inhale, lengthen, exhale. You're holding the block in between your hands and you're now going to a side bend with your arms up. Lovely. Breathing in, back to center. See if you can take a little bit of your hips. Hip. One more, breathing in, breathing out. One more breath, breathing in and breathing out. Relax the arms, let them just hang now. Start doing a full roll down, so that typical Pilates roll. On an exhale, squeeze your stomach back, rolling one vertebra at a time. Really trying to articulate our spine like a, imagine your spine is like a bicycle chain. Make each little nodule roll one at a time. Relax the head, bend your knees. See if you can get your hands near the floor. Make sure your knees are bended on top of your feet, not inside of them. And then just turn your head to the right shoulder, to the left. Imagine you're unscrewing your head from your shoulder. See if you can do that two more times, one more time. And then nod your head, let it hang like a bowling ball, really heavy, like a nodding dog. Breathe in, and as you breathe out, we're rolling. Push the feet down, make sure they're still pointing forward. Squeeze your inner thighs, your stomach, chin to chest, plug the shoulders down, and roll up. Once you're standing, breathe in and roll back down again. Don't let me hurry you. Take your pace, your time, with your breath. So it's always on the breath out that you start rolling, squeezing the stomach in. Letting the arms hang away from your body. So ideally not near your legs, your arms. Once you're down there, get your stomach near your thighs by bending your knees. Lift your hips up, but drop your head. Turn your head to the right shoulder, to the left. Maybe a couple more times. And then nod it. See if it can loosen up anymore. Breathing in to breathe out and roll up. Squeezing the stomach in. Take your time. Into chest, pull the journey up. Lovely. Let's do one more. We'll stay down there now and do four tabletops before coming up. So breathe in. Breathing out. First the head, then the shoulders. Imagine you're like a ribbon that you're rolling into itself to put in a sewing or something like that. Your body is that. So you're really trying to make yourself round, curl up. And then once your hands arrive to the floor, by bending your knees, see if you can lift your hips up, but still keep your hands on the floor. Relax your head again, turn it right, left, bounce it, nod it, see what you have to do to let it feel free. And keep yourself there in that forward fold. I'm going sideways so you see what's happening. Breathe in, push our hands into our shins, for example. Bend our knees more and get a flat back like a table, parallel to the floor. Lovely. And then breathe out, drop down. Relax the head. See if you can squeeze your stomach in and get a little bit further into the stretch. And again, breathing in. Bend your knees, lengthen your spine. Great. Nice. Breathing out, drop down. Again, squeezing your inner thighs, your stomach. Two more. Breathing in. Lengthen it. Breathing out. Dropping, squeezing the stomach. Last one. Breathing in. Lengthen. Can you hold this position now and do three cat cows like this? So imagine you're arching. Look up. Breathe in. And as you breathe out, roll the spine. Keep your knees bent and curl it just a little bit. Keep squeezing the block. Breathe in. Lengthen. Open up the chest and breathe out. Roll the spine. Yes. One more. It's not easy. Breathing in because you want to really keep thinking everything in line still. As you breathe in, open. As you breathe out, roll the spine. And now keep rolling on your breath out to come to standing. So let go of your legs. Roll up one vertebra at a time using that Pilates roll to come out of tabletop. So you stand again. Great. Nice. Grab your hands or your opposite elbows or forearms once you're standing. And let's just open the chest by trying to plug the shoulders down and keep it broad as we turn our head to the right. So you want to exhale here. Try not to move your shoulders. Breathe in, come back to center. And let's go to the other side. Exhale to the left. Remember, you want to turn also your eyes to the corner of the room. Breathe in. Four more in your own pace. So as you breathe out, you're turning. Breathing in, coming back to center. Always with the chin parallel to the floor. Exhale. So notice if you're lifting or dropping it too much. Breathing. Back to center. Two more. Breathing out. Breathing in. Last one. Breathing out. And breathing in. Great. Relax the arms. Let them just hang. And put the fingers on your shoulders. Let's just move the shoulders a little bit by doing circles. So try and bring your elbows together as far as they can. And then behind you, squeeze them together. Forearms, elbows, as much as your body will let you. And then exhale and drop them down through the sides. So you're doing circles with your elbows, basically. But you want to touch them in front of your head. Then behind your head as soon as you're able to. And then exhale as you go dabbly. Let's do one more. See, you can now not drop the head as the elbows go behind your head. Breathe in. And here, see if you can keep your chin parallel to the floor still. Lovely, better. That's it, Carla. Exhaling down to the sides. Let's reverse that movement. Breathing in. Up through the sides. Then turn your arms or your shoulders in. Behind, in front. Exhaling down. Two more. Breathing in. As you open up, back, forward, exhale, down. Let's do one last one, breathing in, behind, in front, exhale, down. Lovely. Keep your elbows pointing to the sides of the room. Make sure you've got space to twist. So I'm going to go a little bit forward. And you just want to go right and left. But notice that ideally you don't want to move your hips. So I need to really squeeze my glutes here. Try not to move your head either. So you're twisting your shoulders against your head and you're looking forward all the time, spotting forward, aligning your elbows with the front and back of them as you twist, yeah? Because they're broad and open. And ideally, you're breathing in and out. In, out, in, out, in, out. That's that kind of science, but I don't want to breathe too heavily into my mic. So you get the gist, right? Let's do eight more, seven, six, five, 4. See if you can still slide the tailbone down and not let the hips move. Imagine I've got my hands on your lumbar spine. I'm not letting your hips move. That's it, better. And then dropping down the arms. Grab your block. We'll work balances and a bit of a stretch and a twist today. So as you stretch up, lengthen your body, bring the block on top of your head. As you exhale, bring the block in front of your chest. Squeeze it and lift your right knee up. And again, breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, stretch, breathe out. Same leg all the time. Breathe in, stretch. Try to keep always your weight on the left foot so you're actually not changing weight as you drop the right foot down. It's just lightly. Breathing in, careful with the hip. Drop the hip down. That's the right hip. So lift with your hip muscle or your hip joints. Breathing in, breathing out. Two more. Breathing in. Squeeze your stomach in, then your leg lift up. Lovely. One more. Breathing in. Can we stay up? Exhale, hold it there. Just do circles with your foot. Just four today. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now keep your foot pointed. See if you can do circles with your knee, like you're stirring your foot. You're stirring a soup with your foot. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now see if you can just lift and drop the hip 4 times. 4, 3, 2. Yeah, just the right hip. And 1. Hold it in the center. Drop the hip. Squeeze your stomach in. Hold it here. Just 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. See if you can just twist to finish off into that stretch. So maybe twist your ribs towards the right. Maybe even look to the right side of the room. Drop that right hip down towards the floor. It's going to help. Squeeze your inner thigh. For 4, for 3. Lovely. For 2. And 1, lovely. Come back to center, relax that leg down. Kick your legs a little bit. Remember that when we do this on the left side, when you lift the left knee up and you want to twist against it, check that your hip isn't here because it's really hard to twist with your hip up. So that's the first thing. Drop it down, exaggerate that. Also, when you're twisting your left shoulder to the back, I always think of pushing my left knee, left hip to the front. So it's a tug of war between those two forces that keeps me in balance, right? So maybe feel that. Let's go to the other side. Breathe, stretch, breathe out. It's the left knee that lifts, not the hip. Nice. And again, breathe in. And breathe in out. Lovely. Breathe in. So that's 2 out of 8. Breathe in out. 3. Inhale. Breathing out. Good. Inhale. Exhale. Full last one. Inhale. Exhale. 3. We're trying to push the stomach in before the leg goes up. Breathe in. 2 more. Exhale. 2. Last one, breathing in. We're going to hold it up and do the same work we did on the other side. So be prepared. Exhale, lift the left knee up. Just find your position here. Notice if your ribs even are back in space. Keep them over your hips. Engage the core. And just hold it there. Do circles with your left toe and ankle. 2, 3, 4. Now with your knee, can we do little circles like we're stirring a soup that's under our knee? 2, 3, 4. Now with the hip. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep your hip down now. Keep your hip down. Lengthen, grow. Breathe in. As you breathe out, if you want to, try and twist. It's the last 8 seconds trying to twist into that balance. Lovely. So much better this side. Nice, Carla. 8 seconds. 7, 6, 5. If you're there, turn your chin round. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lovely. Come back to center. Relax the legs. And we're going to come to the back of our mat. And work on the mat. So is it going to change your camera if you want me to see your mat work, or even grab a bit of water, which is what I'm going to do. So still the block in between our inner thighs and coming to the back of our mat. And oh, you know, we're going to roll down but then roll back up. The work has changed a little bit, just so you're prepared for it. Just 3 times up and down, just so you know. I'll talk you through it. So we're breathing in as we lengthen. That's the breath in. As we breathe out, just like before, first our head comes down, then our shoulders. Bending our knees, rolling one vertebra at a time. Relax, head down. Feeling that forward stretch. Take a moment there. Feel your head still heavy. When you're ready, come to the other side of your mat into that plank position by walking your hands forward and finding a plank here. Push the floor away. All we're going to do is squeeze the block 8 times. So you're going to squeeze and release. Squeeze, release. Squeeze, release. Squeeze, release. Four more. Three. Two. And one. Walk your hands back to your feet. Four steps. Three. Two. One. Relax the head. Let it hang. Breathe in and breathe out. Roll up. Take your time. One vertebra at a time as you roll up. It is the last thing to come up. And as it does, you're breathing in to breathe out and roll again. Let's do it. Exhale. Don't let me rush you. First your head, then your shoulders. Go to your rhythm, to your breath. The important thing is to finish out the stretch. So roll one vertebra at a time till you're standing or till you're in this forward stretch. Feel the movement. Then walk into your next position, your plank. From your plank, we're going to do plank downward dog. Yeah? So you're going to lift up the hips, bend your knees. It's a downward dog with bent knees. That's your breath in. And as you breathe out, you're going to stretch your knees, stretch your spine, curl into your plank. Let's do that again. Breathe in. Lift the hips up and back. Breathe out. Roll into your plank. If this is too hard, put your knees on the floor and do cat-cows. Look up and then down. If you can, exhale. We're going to do 3 more. Breathe in. Stretch up. Breathe out. Roll forward. 2 more. Breathe. Stretch up. Breathe out, roll forward. 1 more. Breathe in, stretch up. Breathe out, roll forward, hold your plank and walk yourself back. 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax the head. Breathe in. And as you breathe out, you're rolling up. And it's the last time we're going to roll up. Now we're staying on the mat. Breathe in. So roll down and stay down now. And as we breathe out, first our head, then our shoulders, squeezing the stomach in, each time a little further in. The more you can squeeze your stomach back, the more you're stretching your spine. So really concentrate on that. Relax the head. And then walk 4, 3, 2. Now this is a little harder, but it's not. Once you get it, it's quite easy. But see if you can bend your knees without moving your hips. So they don't have to bend all the way. You're bent. And then you're stretching, but can you see it's only my knees moving? My hips aren't bouncing up and down. So I'm going to bend the knees and stretch. 1. See if, Carla, you can shift your weight forward into a plank so your shoulders are right above your wrists rather than back. That's it. Let's do it. Bend and stretch. 1. And bend, squeeze the block. 2. And we're doing 4 more. Have a break when you want to. And 2 more. Breathe out. Push the floor away. Don't sink into the shoulders. 1 more. Lovely. And then drop the knees down and stretch your hips back. Take the block away if it was there. Just let your arms stretch forward. Let your head just go around as near to the floor as you can. And breathe deeply. 3 deep breaths. As you breathe out, see if you can squeeze your stomach in. Push your away with your hands to sink your hip back. 1 more breath here. Breathing in. And breathing out. And when you're ready, come in on our hands and knees, guys. Pushing the floor away. And just make sure that you're not sinking, that you're always pushing the floor away. Also with the stomach, that you're not kind of arching and not holding your core, but more you're keeping your natural arch, but holding the stomach back. Same with the neck, it's not dropping, it's more back in space and you're looking down. We're going to combine a few movements. So as you breathe in, see if you can lift your chest up and just kick up today, straight away. Inhale here, as you breathe out, see if you can bring your forehead to touch the knee. Or get close by pushing the floor away with your exhale. And again, let's do 4 more. Breathing in, lift your chest up, look up. Breathing out, forehead to knee. So it's like cat-cows, but with a leg at it. Inhale, look up, open the chest. That's it. Plug the shoulders down there. Yes, and breathe out. Forehead to knee. And again, breathe in it. Two more. Breathing out. One more. Breathe in it. We're going to hold our forehead near our knee for 8 seconds. So forehead to knee for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stretch the leg. Stretch that same leg. Push the floor away. And this is up to you. You can either hold your hands on the floor or lift the left arm up. What to do is 8 little circles with the leg. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Lovely. One other way. Go on, guys. 8, 7, 6. Try and look down so your left arm is in line with your ear. Hold it there. Breathe in. Lengthen. Lengthen the spine. Go on. Hands reach forward, or left hand fingers reach forward. Right toes back. 4 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. And drop down. Well done. Stretch back. Come into a child's pose. But this time your child's pose is going to be walked to the right straight away. So you're stretching the right side of your back, which you have just worked. So try and breathe through it. Sink the hips, walk the hands forward. Let the left shoulder especially drop to the floor. With each breath out, switch the core on. Squeeze your hips back. One more. Breathing out. Come back to the center with your hands. Before doing child's pose to the left, we'll do the other side. So go, come back on your hands and knees. And we'll do those cat cows with our left leg now. Just keep checking that you're looking at the floor once you know what you're doing. Obviously, I understand you need to look up sometimes. But if you can, look floor, long necks. And now you want to look up, open the chest, not sink. Push the floor away. That's your breath in. Breathe out, forehead to knee. And push the floor away. And breathing in. Stretch. Open the chest. Look up. Better. Exhale, forehead to knee. Good. Inhale. We've got 3 more. Breathing out. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. Breathing out. Forehead to knee for 8 seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And hold it there. Stretch the leg. See if you want to stretch the opposite arm. And just do circles. For 8, 7, 6, 5. You can always do it on your elbows, on 2 elbows. If it's on your hands, when your fingers are pointing forward. Other way, breathe in. In and out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold there, just lengthen your leg, lengthen your arm. Be still. 4 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. And drop it down. Well done. Walk the hips back and your hands to the left. So if you were a clock, it would be like 2 o'clock with your arms. Relax the head down. Drop the right shoulder down. It tends to lift. And breathe deeply at least 3 times there. Breathe in it. And as you breathe out, see if you can sit your hips back that little bit more. So one day your hips want to touch your heels. To your right heel when you are with your arms to the left. So sway a little bit your hips to the right heel. That's it. Nice. One more. Breathing in. And breathing out. And then coming back to your center. When you're ready, rolling up. Great. We're going to come to a sitting position and target the core now. So let's go out front of our mat. Make sure you've got a space behind to lay down and stretch your arms, because we'll eventually do that. And we're going to work again. If you've got a block and it's working for you, as long as your groins aren't hurting, your hip flexor, maybe work with your block in between your inner thighs. So you're going to breathe in here, grab your legs and try and lift your chest bone up, plugging your shoulders down, so growing on the breath in. As we breathe out, we want to roll back, but we want to initiate through the breath out and curling the tilt up, C-shape your spine, and then breathe in and lengthen it again. And we're doing four of these, so you want to exhale, push your stomach in, but your tailbone up. And then breathe in, stretch your spine, lengthen. That's it. Exhale. And if you think of your chin, it's always parallel to the floor. So when I lengthen, I'm parallel to the floor. And then when I curl back, it still kind of stays the same. It's only the eyes that drop and look at your stomach and push it in. Let's go for two more. Exhale back. Try and plug the feet down. And inhale as you come up. One more. Breathing out. And breathing in. You can develop this if you want to into a twist or keep doing what you're doing. So you could roll and then imagine that you want to pass something to somebody on your right behind you. And then grab your leg again and stretch up. And that's up to you. Exhale, you could twist it. So you're going first back, then reach, then grab your leg, then up. So it's four movements, one breath. So you're breathing out as you go back, still breathing as you reach back, breathing in as you grab your leg and stretch up. And again, breathe out, roll, reach, hold, inhale as you stretch up. Two more, breathing out, roll, stretch. Hold, inhale up, nice. Exhale, one more. Reach back, hold your legs and come up. That looks good. See if you can let go of your hands. Always, if you put something over your feet, like wedge them in a little gap, it will help you to feel your feet coming off. But if you can, see if you can do it without hands grabbing your legs and see if you can go a bit lower. Again, if you put your feet under something, it might help, might not. See how your body feels. Breathe in and stretch up. So you're going to go back a little bit. Yeah, breathe in and stretch up. And Chris has already read my mind. So you can keep going forward and back, or you can develop that into a twist without holding your legs. Breathe in as you stretch up. So you've got lots of versions there to play with. See what works for you. We're going to do four more of whatever choice you've got. Just make sure your hip flexors aren't hurting. And if they do, give yourself a break. It's not worth it. Exhale as you reach. Inhale. Up. Exhale. Got two more. Breathing in. Exhale. Breathing in. Last one. As you breathe out, whatever version, rolling back, breathing, come up. And now see if you can go all the way back, maybe with your hands as a help on the floor, or maybe you can keep your arms off the floor as you roll all the way back. Put your arms behind your head as you lay on the mat. Breathe in here and then breathe out. Ideally, you're coming all the way up again. And this is four times. If you feel that that's not for you, come up halfway or just use your arm in your breath like we often do. So we'll do that again three more times. Breathing in here, breathing out to roll back, squeezing the stomach in all the way, trying to curl one vertebra at a time into the floor. Breathe in as you reach your arms back. And then as you breathe out, squeeze that stomach, blocking the thighs and roll up. Try to have no sudden movements, all controlled. Breathe in. Breathing out, rolling back. That's it. Plug the shoulders down and away from your ears. One more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Roll up. One vertebra at a time. See if you when you can sit up, see if you can lengthen a little bit more on the breath in. Lengthen your spine. Up, 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 up. That's it. You got it. Exhale, then roll. From that straight spine. Nice, better. And we're staying down now with our head. So maybe you want to, you know, I always do, my feet a little bit closer to my hips. Make sure the toes face forward though. And we're just gonna move our hands. So our arms, better said, back behind the head and down the hips. Never touching the floor. but you do want to imagine that you're actually moving your arms with your core muscles. So as you breathe out, you're squeezing your ribs in, and that's pulling the arms down. Also the stomach and the pelvic floor and the inner thighs, the block. So all of that is connecting as you breathe out, breathe in, and pulling up, stretching out the ribs, stretching out the stomach. So lengthening that muscle. So keep doing that, especially if your neck hurts. But if you want to take it a little bit further, you could lift your head and shoulders up, but just to your shoulder blade tips, not too far. So as you breathe out, you're coming up a little bit, and inhale, going back. We're doing about 8 with our head or without, 8 more. If you are coming up, you want to fit always a golf ball under your chin. So don't choke the chin as you're coming up and down with the head, yeah? And then at the same time, you want to look down, so your eyes do drop down, and you want to look at your stomach and make sure that it's not popping out as you lift your head and shoulders. Let it pop out, squeeze it back towards the back of your body. Even if it's a millimeter, make sure it's going back. And one last thing, and I promise we'll stop. So as you come up, as well as coming down with the arm, down, you want to reach forward. Forward, all that in one abdominal, that's it. And then breathe and go back. Let's do 3 more, thinking of all of that. Breathe out, you're dropping the arms, then forward, inhale, go back. Yes, 2 more. Exhale, and forward, inhale, drop back. Nice. 1 more. Now, deciding to keep your head down all the time, keep it now down, or lift it up now with me and keep it up all the time. And we're going to change our arms, right arm, then left arm, like we did in the warm-up. Breathe in and breathe out 8 times. 7, and breathe in, breathe out 6. Squeeze your block on the breath out. Look at your stomach. You've got 4 more, and 3, push it in, 2, and 1. Lovely. Bring your hands to the block, grab it if you've got one. If not, just keep your hands shoulder distance apart. Take your arms behind you, breathe in, breathe out. Your right leg is coming into a tabletop and your head is staying down. Breathe in, arms back, leg down, change your leg. As you exhale, other leg up. Inhale, change. Exhale, up. Good. And keep going to your breath. All you want to think about is that your stomach going in and your ribs squeezing in, all of that on the breath out is what's making your legs and your arms move. So as you squeeze your stomach in, you're lifting your leg up and pinching your ribs down and in. That's plugging your shoulders down and your arms forward. So if you want to, when you want to, we'll do it more with the head, shoulders. That's your practice today. If your neck doesn't hurt, exhaling as you come up, same thing, head and shoulders or not, it's up to you. Exhaling up, inhale down, exhale. Again, if your groin hurts, give yourself breaks, even let me know so I can really do things that are specific for stretching your hips, your groin. We will do them anyway, but just so you're aware of it. 2 more. Remember, you can drop the head whenever you want to. Exhaling as you come up, inhale as you go down. All I'd say is now try and kick the leg all the way up as you breathe out, and then drop it back down. The movement is changing in that you're stretching the leg now and then bending it down. Exhale, 8 more, with or without a head, that's up to you. Breathe in, breathe out, 7. Nice, breathing in, breathe out, 6. Squeezing the block also, use that to engage your ribs a little more. Exhale, good, breathing in, 3 more, we're nearly there guys. Exhale, 2 last ones, exhale up, inhale back, 1 more there, exhale up, inhale back, great, just bring your feet down, bring the block back in between your inner thigh. We're going to do straight away bridges, but with our arms behind us today. Behind our head, palms face up the ceiling. Unless your shoulders hurt, then you can put them down by it. So let's go. Breathe in, do nothing. Breathe out, start curling your tailbone up. Again, it's like the abdominal work. And then start rolling up now from your hips so you can't go up anymore. When you're at your maximum, breathe in and hold that stretch. As you breathe out, try and ripple down. So if you're sinking your chest bone, then your middle spine, and then your lower spine. Let's do that again. Breathing in, we're doing six. Breathing out, squeeze your inner thighs and roll. Use your stomach in to roll the tailbone up. Once you're at your maximum, breathe in. See if you can really lift the hips, the chest bone, the heart, the lungs. Breathing out, rolling down. Sink your chest, your middle spine, your lower spine. Lovely. Breathing in. Breathing out. We've got one more, but you can take it slower. You can take it even faster, but not too fast. Ideally, you want time to think of all the different things to connect, which is quite a few, right? Breathe. Even up, rolling down. Good. Breathing in at the bottom. Breathe out. Breathe. If you can lift a little bit higher, breathing in. Breathing out. You've got two more, guys. Breathing in. Breathe out. Curl this up, middle spine. Upper spine. Hold it up as you breathe in. Lift it a little higher if you can. Nice. And then breathe out. Try and ripple. Sink the hip, the chest bone. The hips is the last thing. And roll down. Okay, we've got one more. And once we're up there, we're going to lift our heels and drop them 8 times and then squeeze the hips up. Squeezing the block always. Nice. Okay? So now you know what's coming. Breathe in. Breathe out. Roll up. Find a position where maybe you can walk your shoulders a little bit closer or your feet a little bit closer to your shoulders, a bit narrower. So really opening the chest and the hips. And now you're lifting the heels up. Exhale, drop them down. Squeeze the block. Keep the hips up. Let's go. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Out. Inhale. Exhale. That's three. In. Up. Exhale. Four. Inhale. Up. Exhale, five. Inhale, up. Squeeze the block. Inhale, up. Just three more. Oh, stay with me. Two more. Exhale, last one. Breathing. Breathing out. Hold it there. Squeeze the hips up 8 times. Squeeze the block. 7, 6. Go on. We're there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then on your next breath in, rise the hips up to breathe out, roll all the way down. Well done. Lovely. Bring your hands or your arms a little bit wider. So if I were to face you, it probably make more sense. Open them up and down. And then you can keep the block here in between your inner thighs. Your feet can be down or up. We're going to do twists. So you're going to let the legs lower to the right as you look to the left. Breathe in here. Try and plug your shoulders down. As you breathe out, use the block, the inner thighs, come back to center with your head and with your knee. And go the other side. Breathing in. Control the coming down of the legs slowly. Breathing out. Squeeze the stomach and pick your legs up. Bring them to the side of your core. 6 more. Breathing in. Turn your head so that your ear touches the floor one day as you turn it. Breathing out. Coming back to center. Breathe. Let me check it out. Legs to the left, looking to the right. Good. So you're looking opposite to where your knees are going. And breathe out the center. Breathing in. So if your knees are dropping one way, you're looking to the other, away from it. That's it. Better. If your groin start to hurt, remember to keep your feet on the floor. Rather than do 2 more or even it out. And then when you finish your last 2, when you've evened it out, just take the block away. Grab your legs in so I know you've finished. And we'll do a few kicks, stretching the back. Okay, nice. So just as you are, just laying down, just little circles with your knees away from each other so they're not circling the same way. You're trying to stretch your inner thighs after squeezing that block quite for quite a while, right? So you should feel a little bit of a stretch in your inner thighs And then you're going the other way about four times, drawing big circles with your legs. Try not to rock your tailbone too much. So the technique is keeping your hips totally still on the mat, even your tailbone. And then just drop your feet to the floor. And your hands will be by hips. Plug the shoulders down. We're going to do a movement, a kick variation, which we did last week. And then we're going to combine it with a bridge if you like it. You can always do it on the floor twice. So that's up to you. It is good for strengthening the back and the hips and lengthening the legs. So, and the core, it's good for lots of things. So let's work through it. You're going to breathe out and lift the right leg up. So we're going to do it together here, and then we'll do it quicker and quicker. As you breathe in, flex the right foot, kick down, breathe out, kick up. That's one. Yeah, let's do that again. Breathe in, down, breathe out, kick up. That's two. And again, same, right leg, breathe in, breathe out, three. One more. Breathe in, flip the foot as you kick down, breathe out, point it. That's four. On the fourth one, attention. You want to breathe in your right knee and breathe out as you stretch your left leg. You're switching them round, okay? And then we're going the same. Breathe in, flex your left foot. Breathe out, kick it up. That's one. Breathe in, stretch. Exhale, two. You've got two more. Breathe in as you flex the foot. Exhale, as you point, three more. Breathe in, breathe out. That's four. Now, on the fourth one, you're breathing in, bending the knee. And breathe out, lift the other leg up. Let's go one more round each time. Breathe in, flex. Breathe out, kick. One. Breathe in. Breathe out. Two. Breathe in. I need to remember not to blow my breath out into the mic. Sorry about that. One more. Now keep it up. This is the fourth one. So you're bending. Inhale as you bend. Exhale as you stretch. Last round. Breathe in. And breathe out. One. Breathe in. And breathe out, two. Lovely. Breathe in. Breathe out, three. One more. And that's four. As you breathe in, you drop the foot and breathe out. Just relax. Bring your legs in. Hold them there. Plug your shoulders. So try and really get a tight grip of your legs. And then plug your shoulders down. See if you can keep your shoulders on the floor again. Also, your tailbone wants to be on the floor. You're really trying to squeeze your legs in. As you breathe out, a little bit more. And then as you breathe in, let go a little bit of your legs. So you've got room to expand your lungs. Breathing out, squeeze them in one more time. Okay, nice. See if you can ground the feet again and the hands. And you're going to decide, we're going to do that exactly the same. But with the hips up if you want to, and in a bridge position, or down as we just have. So see what you want to do. We're going to do two rounds each side, so four in total, that kick, yeah? And I'm going to talk you through it, so don't worry. Plug your hands into your shoulders. You might stay with your hips down if you're doing it like we did before. If exhale, roll up into a bridge and hold your bridge throughout the movement, right? So you decide this or down. Breathe in and breathe out. Stretch the right leg. Let's go. Inhale. Exhale one. Yeah? Breathe in. Exhale two. Breathe in. Exhale three. One more. Breathe in. Exhale four. Breathe in. Bend your leg. Breathe out. Stretch the other leg. And breathe in. Breathe out. Left leg one. Breathe in. Breathe out. Left leg two. Two more. Exhale three. One more. Exhale, four. Breathe in, bend your knee. Breathe out. Let's do one more round. Stay with me. We'll hurry. And breathe in, breathe out, one. Breathe in, breathe out, two. Breathe in, breathe out, three. Keep your hips high. Go on. Exhale, four. Breathe in, bend your leg, lift one. It's the last round. Stay with me. Breathe in, breathe one. Breathe. Breathe out, two. Two more. And we're done. Exhale, up, one more. Breathe in. Breathe out, lovely. Drop the leg down, lift your hips up, breathe in. And as you breathe out, roll all the way down this time. Nice work. Okay, we're going to go to the side, just as you are. Just see if you can turn to the side and lift yourself up sideways. That's it. And let's try and see if we can work with the right leg forward and the left leg back. And this position is in preparation for planks, but it's also good for the hips to stretch in the groin. See if you can put your right hand. We're going to do two versions of this, and you're going to choose what's best for you. Just start in line with your hip joint, that's the right hip joint, but about a foot away or half a meter. At the same time, you don't want to lean to the right. You want to keep your shoulders right on top of your hips. Breathe in and see if you can just go, as you breathe out, a little bit into a side bend and breathe in, come back to center. So let's just do that three times. That's it. Try to always pull the left hip down as you go to the side. Don't go with the stretch. Push the left hip down. It's not comfortable, but it's very good for us. Let's do two more. Breathing out. Push the left hip down by pressing the right hand into the floor. That helps me. Breathe in. One more. Breathe out. Check what my right elbow is doing. It's bending in, like all the exercises we do when we're standing, right? Breathe in. So you can carry on doing that, or we can go all the way up. All the way up, we'll be on our shins, on our knees, stretching our hip flexors, and lifting up into what would be a side and side plank prep. So that's your breath in. Nice. And then breathe out, drop down. I would like to take some of these. Breathe in. You choose your version. If you want to take it easy, you know what to do now. Breathe in and breathe out. That's two. Good. Breathe in. Coming up. Try to notice if you're sinking. Push the floor away. Don't let yourself sink. And exhale down. Inhale up. We've got three more. And on that third one, last one, we'll hold it. Exhale. When you come down with control, because that's even more important than coming up. Because gravity pulls you down, so you want to work with strength against it. Breathe in, breathe out, control the coming down. We've got one more, okay? We're going to stay up, and we're going to have fruity twists, optional fruity twists. So hold it up. 8 seconds. 7, 6, 5. Try to open your chest to the ceiling now a little bit more, maybe. Let your head fall comfortably wherever it hangs. Push it away with your bottom arm. Hold it there for 4, 3, 2, 1. Maybe come down, or maybe don't come down and look forward. See if you can into a half plank, stretching the left leg along the floor. How does that feel? Maybe you can stretch into a full plank. See where you want to go. 8 seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release down. Release down back into your mermaid and switch the legs round. Well done. Let's go to the other side. Shake your wrists out if there's any pain there. Make sure that you give yourself weight. Also, coming onto our fist is an option. So grounding that right hip down. Don't lift away from it, push it down, and then you want to walk your left hand a little bit to the side, come into that side bend, to the left. That's your breath out, and breathe in, come back up. And again, breathe in out. See if you can bend that left elbow in to your waist. That's it, but slide the shoulder down. Inhale, come back up. And I'd say maybe for some of you, maybe the hand could be a little bit further away, so you actually got space to bend your elbow and not let it pinch your shoulder up, but more slide it down. Yeah. And coming back up. So you can carry on doing that or lift all the way. That's up to you. If you're lifting the hips, bring the hand back under your shoulders. You're stacking. And then we're lifting all the way up 6 times. This is up to you. And breathe out as you drop. Good. Nice. And again, breathing in as you lift. Stretch up, lift up, breathing out as you drop down, and breathing in, breathing out. So you're dropping the hips down as you breathe out, breathing in, and breathing out. Two more, two last ones. Breathing in, breathing out. One more, we'll stay up. Lift the chest, hold it up if it feels good, or in your side bend, but the shoulders down. Let the head relax, open the chest, open the hips. 3, 2, hold it there, or maybe stretch the right leg. This is up to you. Maybe stretch both legs. Last little second, finding our balance there. For for three, for two. Come back to your mermaid. Drop down with your stomach on the floor. I promise we're just going to do one more thing that's very good for our backs, and we'll finish. So we'll have a break in a second. Reach your hands forward. And we're going to do our regular back balancing exercise. Forehead on the floor. You're going to breathe your right leg and your left arm up. That's your breath in. As you breathe out, drop them down and you're changing. So it would be your left leg, right arm up as you breathe in. And then breathe out, change. And keep doing that. So I'm going to watch you because I always feel like I'm talking to the floor when I'm doing this one. You can't hear me. And as you do this movement, changing in your own rhythm, just remember you breathe in to lift and breathe out to drop. There's a few things that it's good to think about or to be aware of in this position. Your hip bones both should be on the floor with equal pressure. So as we lift the leg up, it's very normal to kind of twist to the side and put more pressure on one of the hip bones. Don't let that happen. And that's your core that's going to angle hips down. And it's also going to be your inner thigh squaring your legs off. Go on, I'm counting four more and then we'll hold them and finish off. Three more. Breathing in. Plug the shoulders down but lengthen your limbs. Two more. Breathing in. Lengthen. Breathe out. Drop. One more. And now we're holding. So whatever leg, whatever arm, breathe in. Lift them up for 8 seconds. Seven, go on, reach your leg and arm against each other for four, for three, for two, and one. Drop that arm, that leg, and switch it around. Other arm, other leg. Lengthen them away from each other. Lift them up for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Lovely, drop that leg, that arm. To finish off, two legs, two arms lift. Forehead on the floor, hips on the floor. Inhale, lift, push the world away with your forehead. With your forehead, push the world away. Go on, push the world away with your forehead. That's it, Carla. Now lengthen your body, plug the shoulders down and lengthen your limbs a little bit more. Go on, lengthen a little bit more for four, for three, for two, one. And drop down. Well done, guys. Push your hands into the floor and curl through cat position. Into a child's pose. Last stretch here, right? Just to lengthen our spine. Feel tall before we finish. Breathe in. And breathe out. One more. Deep breath in. And